In this video, I'm going to show you how to take a $20 Wyze camera and turn it into a webcam that you can use with things like Zoom or Skype, or even as a camera for your live stream on Streamlabs or Streamlabs OBS. And we're starting right now. Hi, I'm Orman Beckles, aka the High Tech Nomad, and welcome to another live video. Now, I'm doing this under cover of darkness. It's 3 o'clock in the morning, but I'm doing it now because, as I said, we're going to be doing more live streams, and I really appreciate the support you guys gave me and continue to give me on doing these. I did one earlier today, and the sound was all messed up, which is why I wear the headphones now. But so let's get right to it. I'm going to take this Wyze camera and turn it into a webcam. Now, why would you do that? And well, you might ask. Well, with a lot of people at home, programs like Zoom and Skype and other programs are very popular right now, and you may or may not have a webcam already at home. I have a couple of webcams here. But you may have one of these at home, maybe part of your security system, or maybe even, you know, you got it, or you need to get one. You can get one of these a lot easier and quicker than getting something like the Logitech 920 or 922, because everybody's buying those right now. And those are $100 to $200 a piece, and they're taking a long time to come. Whereas this, you can get like in a couple of days, and it's only $20. Now, it's not the best camera in the world. You're going to see that it's got a little bit of artifacting on it. It's got a little bit of a fishbowl effect, but it will work. And the great thing is that not only can you turn it into a webcam, but when you're done, you can turn it back into a Wyze camera. You don't even have to remove it from your Wyze system. You're going to just go ahead and do that. Now, for those of you who know what Streamlabs OBS, which is what we're using now to live stream these videos, a lot of times you want to have a camera, maybe it's pointed at, I don't know, the fishbowl, or you want to point it outside. You don't want to use a $200 camera. Now you can use a $20 camera to point it at whatever. All right, so let's get right into this. In order to do this, and this is nothing that we hacked or did anything. This is coming officially from Wyze. What they were kind enough to realize that a lot of people are like, hey, I wish I could use that. And they said, well, actually you can. And this is actually also something that a lot of people like myself have asked them to do, because we did want to use these as cheap webcams. So everybody's happy. All right. So what we're going to need is we're going to need a Wyze camera, which we have. We're going to need an SD card, 32 gigs, which we already have. Actually, I have one right in the bottom here. We're going to need the power cable, which I'm sure you already have. And the one piece that you probably don't have is a USB-A to USB-A cable. And so when you order your Wyze camera, you want to order one of these as well, because we're going to need this to complete this project. All right, so let's take a look at our desk here. All right, so we have our Wyze camera. So now Wyze has their own links, but I can never remember those. So I used Bitly, which is a URL shortener, and I've created three links for you here right now. So you can either use my links, or you can go to the Wyze site and try to find what you're looking for. But I think this is easier. So we have three URLs. The first one is called the Wyze Webcam, and we'll go to that one first. And that's going to show us it's going to give us the firmware, and it's going to tell us where we can get it, and so on and so forth. Then when you get ready to turn it back into a Wyze camera, we have another link, which is Wyze Revert Back, and that will take you to the Wyze site that tells you how to reverse it back. It's actually very simple. That's why we're going to go over here now. And then it tells you that you need the firmware, the correct file, to turn it back. And the funny thing was, they didn't leave the link for that. All right, so let's take Let's take the first link and go to their website, which is right there. And it tells us that we have to have all the things that we just talked about. And it says we're going to download a file. It says special firmware here. We're going to download it. And it's going to have a, it's going to be a little file that we open. Very simple and easy to do. So we would download it. And I've already put it into a folder. And I called it Wyze Webcam Firmware. And you can see it's called demo.bin. So we're going to take our SD card and put that in our little SD card piece. Put that right in. And you can see it's already there. And now we're going to take this file. Take this file and we will copy that. Okay. Now it's already started to put some files. If you want, you can format the card first. We'll format it. Just take a second. Bada boom, bada bing, bitty boop. All done. Okay. We'll come back. And we'll just copy that file. So that's the file to turn it into a webcam. That's all we have to do. Copy this file onto the SD card. All right. So now we'll take the file out, take the SD card out. We're going to put that in to our Wyze camera. Plug that right in. There we go. All right. Now it says that we need to hold down the setup key, which is this little button down the bottom. It says we have to push and hold that down while we plug the power in and wait till it's solid and then let go of the button. Took me a while to find out what that little button is. So we'll go ahead and do that now. So I'm going to push and hold that. I'm going to plug this in. I'm holding it. It's a little tough to see. You got power going to that? Okay, let's put that in. Okay, so I got it right there. I'm going to plug this all the way in. Okay, there we go. I'm holding it yellow, 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 blue. It says take your finger off when it turns blue. And then it says it will turn a different shade of blue, which it you're very hard-pressed to tell the difference between these. And then it will blink. Let me turn the Alexa, turn off webcam light.
Okay.
And as you can see, we have the little light in there, and we're supposed to just wait. We're supposed to just wait. And hopefully this will start blinking in a second. And they said this whole process takes about, there it goes. Okay, just went off. And they said when it comes back on and it's blinking, so it's blinking just one light now. That's really tough. They got two lights in there. So we're supposed to just wait until both lights are blinking. And at that point, we can then use it as a webcam. It says it takes 2 to 3 minutes for it to do that. We will wait. It's really tough. Let me get the magnifying glass. Alexa, turn off desk lamp. Because like I said, there's two. Yeah, see, when I look at it underneath of, the magnifying glass, both lights are now blinking. And according to that, this is now, has been now turned into a webcam. so it doesn't take that long. So let's go ahead and check that out. Alexa, turn on webcam light.
Okay.
Here we go. All right, so according to that, once we have the two lights blinking, we can unplug that. And at this point, we can now use this as a webcam, and we're going to use that by using the USB-A to USB-A. So we're going to go ahead and plug that in, and we will plug that in here. And that should come on. All right, that's coming on now. So now we're going to go ahead and test that. So what we're going to do with Streamlabs is we're going to create one called Wyze Camera and add that. So just give me 1 second to do that. And we're changing that over right now. And according to that, we should now be able to add this as a camera. Oh my God, this actually worked while we were doing it live. Awesome. So you can see we're now using it as a webcam. Now, as I said, it's not the world's best webcam. You can see it's got a little fisheye effect on both sides because it's supposed to be a security camera. But this will work, and the microphone and speaker work with that. So again, if this is all you had and you needed to use it as a webcam for Zoom or Skype, this will work. And as I said, if you are a Streamlabs person, you now have the ability to create. So for example, I'm going to mount this on the wall someplace, and I'm going to use this as a studio camera. So people can see what's going on in the background. I might take one and put it outside. I might take one and put it in the hamster cage, for crying out loud, because it's so cheap. You know, it's $20. Now, the process to reverse this is exactly the same. What we would end up doing is we would download the other software. I come back out here for 1 second. So I already have that in a folder. You download what would be the standard Wyze firmware. And this works, by the way, with either version 1 or version 2 of the camera. If you're not sure, just look on the bottom. You'll see it say Wyze camera version 2. So no issue with that. And you would take this file and drag that onto the SD card and do the same thing. Plug the power in, not the black cord that we have, but the original white cord that we have. That's the micro USB. Now we're going to try something here. Let me come back to the overhead. We're going to try something here that I don't think anybody has tried, which is, as I said, we need to use that USB. We need to use this USB-A port, but you may not have one of these cables, or you may not want to use one of these cables. So here's what we're going to do. I got a USB-A to micro USB connector. What I'm hoping is that if we plug that into here, that we now can use a micro USB cable, and that should work as well. So what I didn't think about is I would need a micro USB cable, which I don't have. Let me just come over here. Do we have one? Before, I couldn't find micro USB-C cables. Now all I can find is micro USB-C cables. Give me 1 second. Oh my lord, that was painful. I can't believe I couldn't find a micro USB. All right, so I found a micro USB cable. So now what we're hoping we can do is plug the micro USB cable into here and now plug that in where we had that before. And now we'll try the Wyze camera again, see what we get. We'll give it a second to start up. And we still have the frozen image from before. We may need to deactivate and you saw it here first. Okay. So that means that if you don't want to buy a USB-A to USB-A cable, I'll put a link for that little adapter and that'll be fine. That means you can use whatever cable you have around the house. And it's certainly a lot more convenient than having this USB-A to USB-A. So this adapter is better. You'd plug that in and then you'll be able to use the same cable that you already have with your Wyze camera. All right. Thank you very much for your support and putting up with some of the little technical glitches that we have. And I really appreciate your support. You guys really have no idea. Every time I like, and then somebody writes and says, hey, look, this is great, especially on things like the, autofocus or using DeX or something like that. And as I've said in the other videos, we're now trying to do more live ones, more interactive ones. We're going to be doing some things with Amazon, and we're going to have some guest stars on and some other stuff. So again, really appreciate your support. If this is your first time here, welcome. Please consider subscribing. If you like this video, hit the like button. If there was something you didn't like, tell me. Put it in the comments so that I know what to change and do better. All right, until the next time, this is the High Tech Nomad signing out.